President Trump put Rexnord back in the national spotlight last night with a tweet promising to make the company pay for moving jobs to Mexico.
But for the hundreds of workers that are here in Indiana, Kevin Rader explains why that move comes too late. Kevin.
Yeah, Ann and John, you know, Rexnord is just behind me. If you get a look, and we'll go from right to left here from on camera, if you look at one end of Rexnord to the other, workers tell me the front of this building is entirely empty. By the end of the month, by the end of the month of June, the whole building could be, which is why employees here say the president's tweet rings hollow.
It hit around 7 p.m. Sunday night. That is when President Trump hit the send on this tweet. It read, Rexnord of Indiana made a deal with the Obama administration to move to Mexico, fired their employees, tax products big that sold in U.S.
I asked Mr. President Trump, you're tweeting about Obama, and that's all right to say that if you want to blame it on Obama, but bring back the American jobs. You said that's what you was going to do. We voted you in. The people stood behind you because you was bringing American jobs.
Gary Carter, who works as a machinist at Rexnord, agrees.
I saw the president's tweet last night.
Yeah.
When he was blaming the Obama administration for what happened.
Right. Well, of course.
Who do you blame?
Yeah. You know, I blame the whole big picture. Our legislation, you know, it needs to change. You know, it's our lawmakers. They're the ones that have, for 20 plus years now, these jobs have been leaving one after another, and nobody seems to do anything about it.
I know you got a plate full, but these people here don't have a life. In another 2 or 3, 4 or 5 weeks, they're going to be done. How do you get their jobs back? Just do what you said and try to get our jobs. Keep them from going overseas or other countries.
Clearly, the time for tweeting at Rexnord is over.
And the curious thing about President Trump's tweet is that, as you already heard, he is trying to pin this somewhat on President Barack Obama, former President Barack Obama. And employees here say that may go for a little bit. But they also point out that the governor of the state of Indiana, who knew that those jobs were leaving, was now Vice President Mike Pence. More on how they feel about that coming up at 6. Emery?
Well, Kevin, about those workers, there are about 350 Indiana workers. How many of them are still working and waiting for that 3, 4, 5, 6 weeks to go?
You know, this is a rough and fluid number. From what I'm hearing, Ann, it's anywhere from 180 to possibly 200. Very fluid. We hope to get some more accurate numbers soon.
All right, Kevin, we'll join you again tonight at 6 o'clock. Thank you.